Hey everyone, in this video, we're going to be going through the steps and theory behind the secant method. The secant method is an open root finding method for nonlinear equations. The secant method is very similar to Newton's method, which we talked about in a previous video. I highly recommend you check out that video first, and I will leave a link in the description below for you to do so if you're interested. Alright, so let's now go through the steps of how we implement the secant method and use it to find the roots of a nonlinear equation. Step 1. We must first pick two initial x value estimates around where we think the root will lie. Moving into step 2, we need to generate a first order Taylor series expansion to approximate a function for our secant line. Just as a quick reminder, we use the Taylor series expansion to approximate a continuous function as a polynomial, which is great as the derivative of polynomials are very easy. So, any first order Taylor series expansion will just give us a straight line, which should make sense when we look at this equation, right? We basically have it in slope-intercept form. We approximate the slope of this through using our slope formula like so. Step 3. We must find where the secant line crosses the x-axis, just like we did in Newton's method. We set our output to 0. Then, expanding, we can isolate our function for the input that gives us an output of 0. Now, the x value that we find here is our next iteration's x value. Then, we just repeat the previous two steps until where we cross the x-axis is sufficiently close to our acceptable error. And we can find the error using this formula like so. The biggest difference between Newton's method and the secant method is that Newton's method relies on only a single initial guess, whereas the secant method relies on two initial guesses. You can remember this by the name, as the secant method uses a secant line, which is a line passing through two points of our function of interest. The benefit to this is that we get more stability in finding our root at the cost of being slightly slower than Newton's method. Just as a final note, it is not a good idea to just randomly select your initial guesses for x. We often want to look at a graph and pick values near our root of interest. This will not only make convergence faster, but also much more reliable. Thank you for checking out this video, and I hope it helped your understanding of the procedure and theory behind the secant method, and how we can use it to solve problems. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our Patreon page to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below, and I will do my best to address your concerns.